In a previous video, we discussed why companies decide to use Apache Kafka. In this video, we're going to focus on how data is actually transferred. Specifically, we'll look at Kafka topics. So, Kafka topics are specific streams of data within your Kafka cluster. So, a Kafka cluster can have as many topics as you want, especially with new Kafka mod that completely removes Zookeeper from Kafka architecture. It can handle millions of topics and partitions. It could have names like logs, purchases, tweets, tracks, GPS, and so on. So a topic in Kafka is a stream of data. If you want to compare it with databases, a Kafka topic is like a table in the database, but without all the constraints. So there is no data verification, and you can send any data you want. And the way to identify a topic in a Kafka cluster is by its name. That's why I have logs, purchases, and so on. So these Kafka topics support any kind of message format. For example, you can send JSON, Avro, text, binary, or any other format you want. The sequence of the messages in a Kafka topic is called a data stream. And this is why Kafka is called a data streaming platform, because you work with data streams. You cannot query topics. So while topics are similar to a database table, you cannot query them. Instead, you add data to a Kafka topic. For that, we're going to use Kafka producers to read data from a topic. We'll use Kafka consumers. So the Kafka topic itself is divided into partitions. Each partition can be located on different broker, which enables to horizontally scale Kafka. Also, each topic can be made up of hundreds of partitions. More partitions you have, more parallelism and high throughput you can achieve. But in this example, I have a Kafka topic that consists of three partitions, which are labeled as partition 0, 1, and 2. Now, the messages sent to the Kafka topic are going to be written to these partitions, and the messages within each partition are going to be ordered 0, 1, 2, etc. It's important to understand that only messages within a specific partition follow the same order. That's why it's not an easy task to maintain this order at the topic level, and not so many messaging systems even try to support it. But Kafka can. So the first message goes into partition 0 and will have ID 0, 1, and then 2, and all the way up to 6. As I continue to write messages into partition 0, the ID will keep increasing. So the same scenario applies when I write data to partition 1 of my Kafka topic. The ID will continue to increase, and so forth. So the messages being written into these partitions are assigned ID that increments from 0 upwards. This ID is referred to as a Kafka partition offset. So as we can see, each partition has different offsets. Now, Kafka topics are also immutable. This means that once the data is written into partition, it cannot be changed. We can't delete or update data in Kafka. All we can do is keep adding more data to the partition. Let's take a look at real-world example. Let's say a company has a fleet of trucks. Each truck has a GPS module and it reports its location to Apache Kafka. Then each truck will send a message to Kafka every 30 seconds, for example, and each message will contain some information such as truck's ID and position. So we have a bunch of trucks that are going to act as data producers. They will send data into Apache Kafka, specifically to truck's GPS topic. This topic will contain the location details of all the trucks. Just for example, we decided to create 12 partitions, which is arbitrary number. We'll talk more about how to decide the number of partitions you need at a later point. Now, let's discuss potential use cases for Kafka in this scenario. Specifically, what can be done with the location data. From a management point of view, you would want a dashboard that shows a map and the locations of each truck. And if you run a delivery business like Amazon, you might want to notify your customers when the delivery truck is nearby. In the real world, there would be many more services that would want to access to this data and could use it for different purposes. purposes. That's why Kafka is very beneficial for companies. It eliminates the need to connect each service directly with the truck. Let's take a note of some important things about topics, partitions, and offsets. Once data is written in the partition, it cannot be changed. This is referred as immutability. It's crucial to understand this. Data in Kafka is only kept for a limited time. The default is 1 week, but this can be configured. That means after a week, your data will disappear. Offsets only have meaning for a specific partition. As you can see, offsets are repeated across partitions. So offset 4 in partition 1 represents a message, but it isn't the same data as offset 2 in partition 0. So offsets won't be reused, even if the previous messages have been deleted. They keep increasing incrementally as you send messages into your Kafka topic. That also means that the order of messages is guaranteed only within a partition, but not across partitions. This is very important to understand. Messages within each partition have increasing offsets, which means they are in order. We read them in the order of the offsets. But across partitions, we have no control. We'll see later how we can achieve it if we need it. Data sent to a Kafka topic is assigned to a random partition, for example, 0, 1, or 2. In this example, unless you provide a key. Later, I'll show you what happens when we use a key. In a Kafka topic, you can have as many partitions as you want. Sometimes there are 3, sometimes 10, or maybe 100. We'll discuss how to determine the right number of partitions for your topic later as well. That's all for this video. More to come about Kafka and other frequently used systems in companies. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.